illallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah.
After Musa alayhi salam, Allah appointed a Nabi, a prophet. Who was that prophet? A lot of the ulama are of the opinion that it was the young boy who accompanied him when they went to meet Al-Khidr. There was a young boy who was holding the bag with the fish, the basket, with the lunch. His name was Yusha ibn Noon. In the English language, Joshua. May peace be upon him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us peace as well. So this man was also a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he was the one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permitted to enter Baytul Maqdis, to enter Jerusalem at the time, that promised land. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made sure that with Yusha ibn Nun, nobody from amongst those who worshipped the calf were in his army. Not one of them. So in 40 years, there was a change of generation. And there was a short time left for them to have victory. And the sun was about to set. So he tells the sun, addressing the sun, that Allah has instructed me and Allah has instructed you. And I am telling you, for the instruction that Allah has given me, you will stop at this point for a while. And Allah heard it, and Allah. So it is reported, and this is again an authentic narration of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is reported that that was one day when the sun, as it was setting, it just paused. Exactly how that happened, only Allah knows, and the people who were there know. The Prophet Shuaib alayhi salatu wa salam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the people of Madian. They were the first who started charging people taxes, and they were the first who started taking bribes and so on from people. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if the two parties who are buying and selling, if they are honest and they are clear and transparent, Allah will give them barakah in that deal of theirs. Wealth that is contaminated will bring about disaster. They threatened Shuaib and those who followed him, and they were just a handful. They said, we are going to throw you out. We're going to kick you out. We're going to ban you. These type of words. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us savior. They told him, if you are truthful, we want a piece of the sky to fall on us. Now look at how foolish these people are. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent them such a severe punishment. Large, thick clouds came above them. So it became very, very humid, very, very hot. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala struck them with a tremor. After that, the awful cry overtook them. They died there on the spot. Prophet Ayyub alayhi salatu was salam, known in the English language as Job, may peace be upon him. He was granted good health. He was granted lots of wealth. He was given livestock, as well as large tracts of land, and he had many children.
And not only this, he was very well respected. Everyone respected Ayyub alayhi salam.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to test Ayyub alayhi salatu wa salam, to see this worshipper of mine, who is in constant ibadah, who always thanks me, who always thanks upon all conditions. I want to see if the condition changes, does he remain on that same path of his? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided, Allahu Akbar, to take his wealth away. He lost his livestock, he lost his property, he lost his wealth, he lost absolutely everything. And he continued, he says, never. I know that when Allah tests a person, he tests him this way as well. And he continued and he persevered until there was a time when nothing was operating besides his heart and his tongue. And he still used that tongue to remember Allah. We found him to be very patient. What an excellent worshipper of ours. Indeed, he was oft returning to us. Of Lut alayhi salatu wasalam. His people only had one answer. We need to kick Lut out of our community because he thinks he's very pure and clean. The response of that community was none other than, O Lut, bring the punishment of Allah to us now if you are truthful. Lut, you know we're not interested in the girls. You know exactly what we want. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. These were the people who were punished in the biggest way. They had three different punishments. Allah says, go you now by night. Leave this community and go as far as you can. And do not turn back at all. Early morning, they had the awful cry. It was so loud, it started shaking them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He instructed the angel Jibreel, who was one of them, and he lifted them right up. And then he turned them upside down. Allah says, and then we sent those stones which were baked. Each one had the name of an individual engraved on it. In a very, very short time, the entire community was totally destroyed. There was also one of these for the wife of Lut alayhi salatu wasalam.